Hey, Chris Menard here. I've got a treat for you. We're going to take a look at the 4% retirement or withdrawal rule. We'll use Microsoft Excel to do it. This came out in 94, and every time someone talks about retirement, at some point this rule comes up. I just want to make sure you understand it using Excel, and you know you can tweak some of these numbers. Let's dive in right now. So just to get started, the guy that invented this, Bill Bengen, he still is doing podcasts, still getting interviewed. We'll talk about him towards the end of this because he's made a few changes to this. But in 94, he did a huge study. He went back for 5 decades of stock market data. He was trying to figure out what percentage, if you retired, could you take out of your investment savings and still have money left over after 30 years, so you do not run out of money during retirement. He came up with 4% based on all kind of market data. Great study, but let's crunch the data in Excel, and then I'll tell you some assumptions that I've made and observations I've made about it. Great, great math here involved. So here you go. Cell C1 has got the $1 million that they used. If you wanted to change this to $800,000 or $600,000, you can change this to whatever. It doesn't matter what you change it to. Based on those assumptions, you won't run out. I've got the retirement age at 67. If you notice, 67 is also down in cell A6. If I make that 65, everything changes and we still are running out for 30 years. I'm going to go back to 67 in this example. There is the 4% that Bill came up with. 4% of 1 million is 400,000. So year one, we've got $1 million in investments. We take out 400,000, but we're still gaining on our investments. The gain percentage I've got is 8%. That's what they came up with. And we have inflation sitting at 2%. Just one of my observations right here is that, one, this is based on 30 years. You could pull up your Social Security. I'll put a link to this, life expectancy. And for example, a lot of the life expectancy is 84 to 86 years, usually for people that are around 60 years old. But it could be more and it could be less, but we're going out for 30 years, so that'd be 96 in this example. Also, Social Security Administration, whatever check you would be getting, if they pay you $3,000, $3,500 a month, that is not considered in here. Spending habits are not considered. What do I mean by that? Usually when people retire, the first few years of the retirement, they seem to spend more money than that really long middle retirement stretch. The reason for that is they're traveling and they're doing the cool stuff that when they're working, they couldn't do. Also, all percentages are consistent, meaning the stock market historically earns 8 to 10%. I've got it as 8%, but in real life, that doesn't always happen. If you recall back in March of 2020, coronavirus, stock market crashed, went down over 33% in just that month. Also, inflation, I've got it as 2%. Back in July of 2022, inflation was 9.1%. So we can tweak all these numbers. Here we go with the math, though. The $1 million came down from cell C1. We're going to withdraw the 40%. One important note about this that people get wrong, that 4% is only on the initial year. So 4% of a million is 40,000. There's our stock market gain. There is our balance right there. Just some math involved there. And then here's the cost of living. So the 40,000 year one is not 40,000 year two. It is the 40,000 added on with the cost of living. So 2% of 40,000 is 800. Therefore, it's 40,800 year two. Same thing on year two, we get another 2%, taking us up to 41,616, as you can see right there. At the end of 30 years, based on this, we will have over $4 million still remaining. So let's tweak this a little bit. Let's say you believe that inflation is going to be 3% and that your investments are going to be only 7%. Now we're not ending up with $4 million, but we still have over $2 million. Let's also assume that you decide, you know what? I'm going to go a little higher than the 4%. I want to do 6%. Bill has recently come out, by the way, and said that that 4%, now that he's looked at this data again just recently, and I'll put links down below, he thinks you can go higher than the 4%. So now I've got this at 6%. There's your 60,000. You do, though, run out of money at age 92 in this example if you retire at 67 right there. So maybe in this example, you make it 5.5%. Still running out when you're 96, all right? I'm going to go back to the 4%. I'm going to go back to 8% and 2%. Another cool feature with this Excel file, you can come over here. I am just throwing this out. Let's say that after year one, the stock market tanks and you lose 30, 35% of your money. I'm just going to type in a number here. I'm not going to do the formula. Let's make this 700,000 right here. We were ending up with over 4 million. Now we got 983,000 just from that huge decrease that year right there. In fact, we actually never catch back up at 8% and 2%. We never actually catch back up to that balance. I'm going to undo. Now we're back here again. Anyway, I will have this Excel file available for you to download. I'll also have some recent podcasts where Bill was interviewed. Just great stuff. I love what he did. I love that he came up with something. I occasionally hear people complaining about the 4% rule, and I'm like, well, you come up with something then. It's like in that meeting at work when you have a suggestion, and then people complain about it. I'm like, well, you figure it out then. Anyway, appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. Have a great day. Thank you.